Today, we're making some magic and taking you inside the Apple Vision Pro, the new Apple headset that everyone's talking about. What's up, Internet? I'm Brian MacDuff, aka BMac, and welcome to another video. So I've had the Apple Vision Pro for a few days now, and there's a lot that I've been testing and trying out with this thing. But instead of me just talking about my experience with the Apple Vision Pro, I figured it'd be pretty cool if I actually took you inside the headset to give you a quick little demo and a hands-on, or I guess in this case, a eyes-on walkthrough of what this thing is actually capable of. So with that having been said, pull up a chair, max out the video resolution of this video, and get ready to take a look inside the Apple Vision Pro. All right, so here we are inside of my Apple Vision Pro, and as you can see, right now I have my Vision Pro environment turned off. And in this mode, we're basically in an augmented reality mode. You can see and interact with all your different apps and windows, or any objects within apps, and you can move all that around and basically pin them within your space where they're gonna stay. And it's really in this mode where you can see the spatial awareness and spatial computing aspects of the Vision Pro really starting to impress. But you do also have the ability to utilize the Vision Pro environments, which is basically invoking a virtual reality mode. You could turn these on and immediately be immersed in environments like Yosemite, Mount Hood, or even the moon. It's super realistic, feels like you are really there. And the attention to detail is just incredible. I mean, in some of these environments, you could actually even yell and you're gonna hear an echo coming back to you with the Vision Pro. Personally, I find myself using environments when I'm using the Vision Pro while remaining stationary and turning off environments when I'm moving around or needing to interact with the space around me for spatial computing. From here, all I have to do is press the digital crown on top of the right side of the Vision Pro headset itself to bring up the home view. And to interact with the Vision Pro, everything basically comes down to your eyes and your hands. There's eye tracking built right into the Vision Pro headset that detects where I am looking and will immediately highlight any selectable items. So as I'm looking back and forth between the different app icons within home view, you could see the Vision Pro highlighting the different app icons in real time. From here, I can use a pinch gesture with my hand that will select whatever the Vision Pro is highlighting, which in this case will launch the app that I'm looking at. Once the app is launched, using your eyes and your hands is also how you'll actually interact with the different apps on your Vision Pro. It's how you can move the app windows around, adjust them within my space, adjust their size, or even close them, all using just my eyes and pinched gestures. Now, in terms of typing, you'll notice that whenever I look at and then select an area where text input is enabled, the Vision Pro automatically brings up its keyboard, which I could then use in one of several ways. I can use eye tracking to highlight the individual keys I need to press to type out my words with pinched gestures, or I can use a pinched gesture to bring that keyboard closer to me, at which point I could actually interact with the keyboard itself by virtually press typing. Or, what is perhaps the easiest way, is just looking at the voice dictation icon and selecting it through eyesight tracking in the pinch gesture like we've been mentioning, or by virtually pressing it with my finger if the keyboard is close enough to me. That'll allow me to actually voice dictate whatever it is I want to search or type in, and it's probably the quickest, easiest way to do so. I will say that typing has been pretty darn slow, tedious, and maybe even a little wonky at times if you're typing with your eyesight and pinch gestures or with those virtual type presses. To really take advantage of fast typing interaction with the Vision Pro, I found that you almost absolutely need to use voice dictation, or you could actually do what I do sometimes and connect your Magic Keyboard to the headset. But hopefully the typing experience altogether will get better with future OS updates, because a simple update like slide to type, like we currently have for typing on the keyboard within iOS and iPadOS, could make a tremendous difference in bettering your typing experience on the Vision Pro. Right now, again, at the time of making this video, there are currently hundreds of apps already natively supported and designed for use with the Apple Vision Pro, but you do also have, as you can see here, a compatible apps folder, which is where you'll actually be able to download and store a bunch of different iPhone and iPad apps that are compatible with the Vision Pro. You could search for the app you want to download and see if there is a native app for it within the Vision Pro App Store, or you could always switch over here to the iPhone iPhone and iPad app section, which will allow you to download it that way. Once you download one of these kinds of apps and launch it, it'll appear as an app window within your Apple Vision Pro space, but it's basically like a large iPhone or a large iPad screen, and that's how you could interact with it as well. This is how I'm currently using X or Twitter and a few other apps. Now, if I don't see an app available as a native Apple Vision Pro app or as a compatible iPhone or iPad app, I'm actually finding myself able to get by simply going to Safari and opening up the web app. This is exactly how I'm actually using Instagram on my Vision Pro, and it seems to be working pretty darn well. Now, in terms of notifications, those are gonna pop up on the top of my field of view, which I can easily access simply just by looking at it. Once again, eyesight tracking here. And if I do that pinch gesture with my hand, it's actually gonna open the notification view and show me what it is. Similarly, this is also how you'll access your control center. All I have to do is look up in the Vision Pro, and I'll see that little icon. And once I'm highlighting it, I just use my pinch gesture. It's gonna select it. Then I go to Control Center, and here's where you have all your Vision Pro Control Center options. Pretty much just like how it works on an iPhone or an iPad. One last thing I definitely want to show you here is if you have a Mac in front of you, like the MacBook Air that I have in front of me here. The Vision Pro could actually detect that Mac within my space and then allow me to connect to it, at which point a resizable window appears in my Vision Pro that basically acts as an external monitor. Pretty cool, really awesome, and sometimes super helpful way to actually expand the size of your monitor without having to go out and get and set up and connect an actual physical external monitor yourself. This is also a pretty cool example of everything we just talked about coming together as I walk throughout my music room. You can see I have a little sticky here set up for the next vinyl I want to buy. And I also have separate windows for the different kind of controls within this room. One is going to show me the volume level and the input selection that I have for my speakers. And I even have a little app window in the corner of the room that uses Shazam to detect whatever song my vinyl record player is playing. We have some sheet music where I left off on the piano for some piano playing. And if we head on over to the guitar, you can see I have a window left here that's teaching me the chords of one of my favorite songs. So hopefully that gave you a pretty solid intro into what the Apple Vision Pro is all about, how you use it, and what it's capable of right now, and especially how I'm using it in my daily workflow. I'm clearly geeking out on this new piece of tech. I've been all over Twitter and Instagram talking about it, but if you have any questions regarding the Apple Vision Pro, feel free to ask those questions in the comment section below. If it's in regard to how something works, if something's possible, leave all those questions in the comment section below. I'll get back to as many as I can. Hopefully I have the answer, and if not, hopefully I'll get to the bottom of it. And you know by now, if you want the latest deals, prices, promos, and information for the Apple Vision Pro, you could of course always head to my affiliate link, bmac.link/visionpro. Of course, there's gonna be clickable links in the video description box and in the comment section below as well, so check those out. Now that this video is filmed, I actually have to go edit it, which maybe I'll try doing with the Vision Pro. Give that a whirl. But thank you so much for watching. Don't forget to smash that thumbs up button, subscribe, and I will see you guys in my next video.